Hi, I'm Jack with Upton Bass String. I'm Jack with Upton Bass String Instrument Company. Today we're going to do a string change. But the only thing you really need to do this is a string winder. A number two pencil is advisable, and a tuner. This bass here has traditional orientation of the pegs, so the E is closest to the nut shelf, and the D is the furthest from the nut shelf. So that being the case, I'm going to start with the bass strings first. I'm just going to remove two at first. I'm going to remove the E and the A string and leave the D and the G strings. If you have reverse orientation, I would probably start with the treble strings first, meaning the D and the G. Usually what will happen is once the windings start to really come loose within the peg, a lot of times I can grab the end. Be careful, because sometimes it is sharp, and I'll just push it through, and then I can usually get this, grab the string and pull it, and then I can usually start to remove it much quicker once I get the string out of the hole. Some people put strings where they wrap it through the hole a bunch of times. I don't really find that necessary with most modern strings to do that. A little something underneath the tailpiece here to prevent any scratching. Carefully remove the two old strings. We're gonna work our way from the outside in, meaning from the outer part of the nut inward. And we'll do the same thing in reverse when we get to the other side. Refreshing the string slots with a little fresh graphite from a number two pencil. So a little bit on the E, a little bit on the A. And again, here at the nut, same thing. A little on the A and a little on the E. That's good. Now is a good time if this fingerboard's really nice and clean. We just did a fingerboard dress on it here in the shop. But if you're doing it at home, four lot steel wool is a good idea sometimes to clean up the fingerboard surface. And you can freshen that back up too with a little bit of linseed oil or a product called Danish oil. So now we got a nice new E string. This particular bass has a pickup on it, so we're just gonna reuse the P clip and the felt washer. Slide that through carefully down through the string. Okay, once it gets past there, it'll start to go pretty easily. And on its way down. Okay, very good. And then just try to be careful and just put this string through the tailpiece. Try to be careful not to let it slide around too much on the bass. Make sure this thing is in properly, more like that. Okay. Make sure it's up into the slot properly. A lot of slots here are not opened up enough. So sometimes you might want to grab a rasp, a small little mini rasp, and open that up a little bit. Starting with E string first, as already described, I'm gonna put it into the hole. About a half inch or so on the string coming through the other side is fine. A little more is okay. A little less is okay as well. So the key here at first is try to hold the string nice and, you know, over the bridge with your fingers here, and then I'll use my index finger here to hold the string like this and start winding. Now the thing we're gonna do first is we're going to wind away from the cheek here of the scroll. We're gonna wind this way first. We're gonna wind inward, if you would like to think of it that way. Each string manufacturer is a little different. Some string manufacturers will have more string you'll need to wind onto the peg. Other strings will have less. I never cut strings. On rare occasion, I'll have to cut a gut string just because they're so thick. It's a good point to point out, what I'm gonna do here next. On an E string, I usually, with most brands, I'll get about three wraps around the peg, and then I'll start to cross it over like this. That will cinch the string. That will eliminate any slipping. Plus, just the way the string is designed, it's really, all this threading here really makes it near next to impossible for the string to slip. I really only see strings slip like this when you're reusing them and they're very, very old. Sometimes they will slip, in which case then you may want to put the string through that slot in the peg several times. Now, the reason I only wrapped it about three times on the E string and then crossed it over is I'm trying to maintain a pretty straight line from the nut into where the final winding on the peg goes, which is pretty close right now, considering I got no tension on it, really. There's no pickups to worry about with this A string, so I'm just gonna carefully slide it through. Try to be careful of the string coming through that it doesn't whack into the bass. Make sure it's up into that string slot there. The A string, we're gonna wind very similarly to the E string. The only real difference that I do on the A string is I'm gonna have more wraps going in this direction than I will on the E string. So I'm gonna wrap almost this entire string onto away from the pegboard, away from the peg box inner wall here. Sometimes it's a good idea at this point to lower the tension on the D string. Or if you're doing reverse orientation, it would be removing tension on the A string. So I'm going to keep winding here just about almost the entire string. I'm getting close to the end here now. I'm going to cross it over. And now you can probably see why I did that, because it's going to allow this nice straight line coming from the nut into the peg. I'll throw a quick tune on these two strings. And the G now. So we're going to start from the outside and work in. So that would mean we're going to move on to the G string. I usually kind of pinch my fingers like this, prevent the pencil from going all over the place. We'll be the same concept that's going to apply on the G as it does on the E, meaning my objective is to try to get the winding so it's pretty straight coming off of the nut itself. So again, I usually do about 3 to 4 windings depending on the manufacturer. The windings don't stack up as fast, so switching it over, sometimes it's a little earlier, sometimes it's a little later than you do the E string. But again, just try to, each manufacturer is a little bit different. Great, okay, so there's the G. Just enough tension to hold it into place. The reason I did these two first and the treble strings last is this is the last string, so it's gonna go over everything else that I've wound. And again, now we're gonna wind away from the gear first, or away from this gear, you know, towards my left. And again, same idea as I did on the A string. I'm gonna wind up almost this entire string. So again, just about wound up entirely, crossing it over here now to the final winding here. And now I got nice, pretty nice, even string paths here. Let's tune it up and see what we got. And that's just about done. The last thing we'll do after we tune it is check the bridge, make sure, usually the bridge was gonna pull forward, so we're gonna check that. Looks like it's leaning like this, then just, pull it back until you can look at it and eyeball it and be close. 41 1/4 was the string length on this bass. It's a little weird number, I know, don't ask. Other thing to keep in mind is certain strings are going to stretch out more than others. These metal strings like this one, meaning a core is primarily made of metal, are gonna stretch less than a composite core or a nylon core string. Those ones tend to stretch out more, so don't panic if you wake up the next day and you go to play your bass and it's a whole step flat. perfectly normal for a composite string to do that. Same true if you're using anything that's natural material, like a gut string. Obviously, those strings are going to take longer to stretch out. Break in time on a metal string like this one, this Tomostic Spire Core, is probably 12 to 24 hours. Usually with new strings, the bridge tends to like to pitch forward a little bit overnight or with it over 24 hours. So keep an eye on the measurement here of your string length. Most players that I know usually know the measurement here up front. Thanks everyone for watching. Obviously, if you have any questions, you can always give us a call here at the shop. Again, this is something that's definitely what I would consider home maintenance, something you can do yourself. Thanks.